Edgy.
No live
edgy.
Action edgy. Justice League
rated R.
These people are clowns. They're being laughed at all over the world.
Okay, the positive comments video is coming, I promise, but I gotta talk about this. Well, I don't gotta, I just want to. Because when more information comes out about this movie, it means more people come out of the woodwork to hate it, which means I can make another video, which means business is booming. You would think I get tired of making these, but I really don't. So the rating for Zack Snyder Justice League has been revealed, and it's rated R. And apparently this is a problem, because there's never been a rated R comic book movie before. Never, none at all. Especially not in the DC Extended Universe. I mean, unless you count Birds of Prey, and Batman vs Superman Ultimate Edition, which was the second film in the DC. EU. And also James Gunn's Suicide Squad is gonna be rated R too. But the way people are reacting to this bit of news makes it seem like he's making it into an X-rated porn. I'm serious, this is throwing a lot of people into a frenzy. But most people seem to think that Snyder's just making the movie super edgy and super dark, which is why it's gonna be rated R. I'm gonna be honest, I don't think that's what it is, because if it's anything like the Batman vs Superman Ultimate Edition, then it won't really be that noticeable. Realistically, what's different from the Ultimate Edition versus the theatrical cut? You see Ben Affleck's ass, and there's some extra blood. That's about it. Not really pushing the boundaries of what you can do with an R rating. So I don't think it's gonna be much further than that, honestly. It's not like we're getting a graphic sex scene. It's just gonna be more violent, and Batman says fuck. But people are definitely overreacting to this. I mean, besides all the other R-rated comic book movies out there, if you actually look at the animated movies, there are several that are rated R. And generally speaking, animated movies, or cartoons, are intended or designed for children. So why is it these characters can be featured in R-rated content like the animated movies, but you can't do it with live action? Most of these comments are just the whole think of the children routine. They act as if they never watched an R-rated movie back when they were 10 or 11. Or 12. They act like this is gonna damage the kid's psyche and scar them for life. And some people might think, well, that was back in the day. That was, you know, maybe 15, 20 years ago. Times has changed. In reality, it really hasn't. A recent example? Deadpool. Both those movies are rated R, and both have a huge amount of fans that are kids. A lot of preteens and tweens. And that movie is a hard R that has a lot of messed up stuff in it. You want another one? Logan. Kids love X-Men. Kids love Wolverine. And more recently, Joker. My younger siblings, who are minors, love that movie. Also, going back to Deadpool for a second, I myself saw it in theaters, and there were dozens of kids there. If you saw Deadpool in theaters, how many kids did you see there? I imagine quite a lot. Basically what I'm saying is, this is not a big deal. Not only has there been R-rated comic book movies, but these characters themselves have been featured in R-rated animated movies before. Not to mention, a lot of these comic books that people say are just made for kids get pretty damn dark. Like I already said, I don't think it's gonna go much further than Batman vs Superman Ultimate Edition. I definitely believe it's gonna be more violent, and some more profanity. But it's not gonna reach Deadpool's level in any way. So let's go ahead, go to the internet, and see how they're taking the news. The fact that the Justice League movie is rated R is cool and all, but it's totally unnecessary. Just doesn't seem like the type of flick that has to be R. But it is because it wants to be edgy and cool. Yeah, that's the one we're gonna see the most. People saying it's only R because it wants to be edgy or cool. So Superman is gonna be snapping more necks and dropping more buildings on people's heads? So edgy. We still blaming the destruction of Metropolis on Superman? Okay, sure. I feel bad for those kids who won't be allowed to watch it. I firmly believe, unless there's like hardcore sex in it, parents don't really care what their kids watch. I mean, there definitely are strict parents out there who don't want their kids watching R-rated stuff, but these days 10-year-olds know how to operate Netflix all by themselves, so I don't think most parents will really care. Edgy, he says with a Tim Burton Batman profile picture. The Justice League, the most famous superhero team who was made for every age, colorful, fun, timeless, and awesome. And what we got? An R-rated movie. Why? Just why? And why should I care for Batman saying the F-word? Why a Justice League movie needs an R rating? Again, I think this is people just taking the R rating and thinking of the most extreme things they can think of. I seriously doubt it's gonna go as far or as extreme as they think. I really agree with this guy right here. Wait, you're telling me the movie where this guy is the antagonist is rated R because of violence? This really came out of left field. And he has several pictures of Steppenwolf just massacring people. Oh, this is Mercury. I actually know this guy. His reaction is perfect, and the people who can't handle it can watch the version made for them. So unnecessary. And somebody else I know replied to this saying, totally. I mean, think of the incredibly wholesome kid-friendly comics. Damn, Yoda, you gotta do him like that. Oh, there's a follow-up. I love when I shut a barking dog. You block someone because they counter your argument? That's just a way of admitting that you lost. The Justice League characters are designed for kids. The fact that they're not going to be able to see this new and maybe better version is just massively disappointing. People are so desperate for these characters to be taken seriously that they're forgetting who they're for. Again, most of the animated movies and cartoons are made for kids, and yet a lot of those get PG-13 and even R ratings. How sad not to have the creativity or moral example to create a superhero movie without that level of violence and profanity. What a sad, cynical commentary, not interested, from someone who loves superhero movies. Well, from someone else who loves superhero movies.
Shut the fuck up! Those nuts!
And I keep coming back to this. What do you think is going to be in this rated R movie? Judging from Batman vs Superman Ultimate Edition, I don't think it's going to be that extreme. And hell, look at another DC character, Constantine. That movie was rated R, and it definitely didn't feel like a rated R movie. Ooh, edgy visuals. Ooh, rated R. Lol. Give us a better plot that the original did, then we talk. Well, we gotta see the movie first to know exactly how the plot goes. I'm totally down with R-rated superhero movies if they choose the right character. None of these characters, except maybe Batman, have any reason to be rated R. Now this one I kinda understand, because Batman is a darker character, he always has been, so it really wouldn't be surprising if he got a rated R movie. I mean, hell, he's already appeared in several animated rated R movies. But then again, so have other characters that they listed. Superman, Wonder Woman, they appeared in rated R stuff as well, usually alongside Batman. We got a little thread going right here. No live action Justice League movies should be rated R. Why not? Explain, please. These characters have mass appeal in popular media. Toys for kids, TV shows for all audiences. Why make a movie on this scale and then limit the target audience? The R rating is pointless. That doesn't amount to any sort of reasoning. Logan had toys as well as Deadpool. Seems to me they don't care. Yeah, exactly. With Logan and Deadpool, they're both rated R movies, who technically speaking should be targeted at adults since it is 17 and older. Surprisingly did very well in terms of merchandise and toys. And like I already mentioned, most of the fans are pretty young, especially back when their movies came out. So clearly the R rating did not hinder the success of either of those movies. Now this is a hilarious thread you gotta check out. Not sure the authority that you checked with, but if you can kindly forward a link that we may all view that ordinance that say, superhero movies are for kids, appreciate it. You never know until you know, I guess. And then we gotta checkmark that replies to him. Hey there, professional critic, tomato meter approved here, superhero movies are for kids. He comes in with them credentials, tomato meter approved. As if that fucking means anything.
Nobody cares.
Someone replied with this great meme. I am tomato meter approved, and this gives you power over me? Now, the reason I'm clowning this guy so hard is because it gets even better. You ready? Not every superhero movie is for kids, and there's good examples of them. Who made you the one to decide what audience they have to be made for? Good question. Is that one of the perks of being tomato meter approved? He replied with, they're all for kids, actually. Like The Boys, like The Punisher, like Deadpool, like The Rat Pack, like Invincible, like Blade. All for children, yes. The Boys? Really? Have you even taken the time to read that? My son, a child, read it. I got the gist. How is it in any way for kids? Men in capes? Laser beam eyes? Come on. That's what I call bullshit. There's no way that he'll be okay with his son reading The Boys if he's not okay with Justice League getting an R rating. Because that definitely is not made for kids. The show actually tones down a lot of stuff from the comic. I just want to end off with a few more people making some good points. Zack Snyder is just an edgelord. These comics are just for kids. They aren't violent. And then he shows some images from comics, all of which involving different characters from the Justice League and the main antagonist of the Justice League movie, Steppenwolf. I'm actually really curious if the people who say that comic books are just for kids have really read one. Because a lot of them really aren't made for kids. That doesn't stop, you know, kids from reading them. Just saying there's a lot of mature content in comic books. My fellow adults whining like, kids won't get to watch the Justice League film. As if when we were growing up, we didn't watch Total Recall, Terminator, Face Off, Friday the 13th, Enemy of the State, Die Hard, Under Siege, etc. before we were even tweens. LOL. Not even on the low. Exactly, like I said earlier. A lot of us watch R-rated stuff when we were kids. My guess is most kids will be watching it anyway, unless they're really young. It's available at home via streaming. The R rating is for violence and a bit of profanity. As a culture, we're pretty much desensitized to that. Sexual content is usually the deal breaker with parents. I wonder how many parents allow their kids to watch Game of Thrones, which I suppose by the same logic of detractors here, was rated R just to be cool and edgy. Yeah, exactly. When it really comes to violence, we're desensitized to it, but again, I don't think it's going to be that extreme. It'll go further than Batman or Superman, but I don't see it being over the top. And that's going to do it for the video. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, go ahead and drop a like on it. And go ahead and leave a comment. Let me know what you think about the Snyder Cut being rated R. Personally, just not really surprised and don't think it's going to be that big of a difference. I don't see it going too far or too over the top. People are thinking of like the most extreme examples of rated R material and then applying it to the movie. Like, bro, this isn't Sin City, okay? This isn't 300. That's gonna be it. Alright, get out of my face.
My lord and master Aku, may it please you for all eternity, the samurai is dead.
Extra thick